Hunter Biden's laptop shows that he met with his father at least 30 times at the White House or the vice president's residence, and it was often just days after Hunter returned from a trip overseas. Miranda Devine joins us now. You know, Miranda, this directly contradicts the president's repeated denial about his son's dealings, right?
It does, Ashley, and it's just one of a mounting number of pieces of evidence that also contradict the president's repeated claim, which now looks like a lie, that he knew nothing about his son Hunter's overseas business dealings. He maintained that throughout the campaign and now throughout his presidency. And look, there's a new poll that's coming out this morning from Rasmussen, which shows that the majority of Americans, 69%, do not believe the president. They believe that he knew about Hunter's business dealings, and a majority also believe that he profited from some of those Chinese deals. I think that this is becoming an unsustainable problem for the White House, and they have to address it sooner rather than later.
But, you know, the mainstream media is ignoring it, basically putting it off as a right-wing conspiracy theory. At what point does the mainstream media have to acknowledge it?
Well, that's a very good question. It took the New York Times 19 months to even acknowledge in the 24th paragraph of a story that the laptop is real and that they'd authenticated some of the emails on it. That was after ignoring and introducing our story back in October 2020 when it counted before the election. It's too late now. I think a lot of people are having Joe Biden remorse, so maybe they're paying a closer attention to this story. And I think that, you know, there's a grand jury in Delaware that's been looking at Hunter Biden. If they come out with indictments, it will be impossible for the media to ignore it.
I want to change topics, Miranda, quickly. You have a new op-ed out. It reads, there's only one New Yorker Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez fights for herself. Is it that bad?
Well, it is. New York is in a parlous state, especially when it comes to crime and the cost of living. Yeah. Her constituents in Queens and the Bronx are more interested in that than in more selfies, more videos, more self-indulgent ranting about, you know, some guy on the steps of the Capitol who catcalled her. It was offensive, but it didn't require her staff to call the Capitol Police 5 times and then for her to just continue on for days with these rants on social media, basically calling the cops insurrectionists because they refused to come to her rescue after she was catcalled by someone who never came near her. And this is the person who wanted to defund the police, but she actually wants a private police force at her beck and call.
She also repelled Amazon's, you know, new headquarters, which would have provided massive amounts of money, huge amounts of jobs, but that's AOC. Miranda Devine, we're out of time, but thank you so much for talking with us this morning. Thank you very
much.
Ashley.